Lou gone, that changes the fourth quarter and how you guys played, obviously. More minutes now for some of those younger guys as well.
Yeah, I mean, Lou was great for us. I mean, on and off the court, what a pleasure he was to coach. What a great locker room guy he was for these youngsters. So with him not on the floor, it's gonna require that some of these other guys step up and make plays, because he bailed us out a lot this year. And you know, without him there, you know, there's only two options: you give in and you get blown out, or you find a way to make something happen. And with the group we have, I expect that they figure it out and find ways to get it done and keep us in games and have us competing.
It's sad, you know. It really didn't hit me until today. You know, when you come out here and he's not there, you know, just his presence, you know, his personality around the team was big. Forget about the stuff he does on the court, that speaks for itself. But just how he was around his team, you know, the vet that he was for us, he was big time.
What was practice like without him?
It wasn't the same, but, you know, guys stepped up. You know, guys came in locked in, like I said, and focused.
You know, it was tough, but I feel like, you know, it was a move for us. You know, Lou's was like a big brother to me. You know, played with him, you know, for these like 2 years, and, you know, on and off the court. You know, he was kind of, you know, the guy that was talking to me all the time, and, you know, guiding me. So, you know, for me, it's one of those things, you know, like, just like everybody else, you know, losing, you know, friend, teammate. But it's something we just got to do to move forward.
Luke said the first time a player got traded when he was a young guy, he was devastated. He thought the world stopped. What was it like for you when you heard Lou was not coming back?
That was a little heartbreaker. Of course, that was my bet. And just taught me a lot of things on and off the court, just in general. Always joke with me, always laugh with me. Of course, he was a great player and a great person. So, of course, it was a loss to our team.
Have you texted with him?
Of course. As soon as I saw it, I had a chance to reach out to him. And just gave me a few words of wisdom.
You said Lou was your vet, and you went to him for a lot of advice. Now that he's gone, when you look back at it, what do you think you'll be your biggest memory of Lou? What's the biggest piece of advice he's given you?
Just always putting the hoop first. I think always putting basketball first. The things around that we got, the way we can take care of our family, the way we can do anything outside the basketball floor is because of the hoop. So just always come back here and remember why you can do these things for your family, why you can do these things for the people around you.
What do you think of Lou getting traded? This happens this time of year, but still, it's a teammate.
Like you said, it's a business. I mean, he was more of a original, I don't know, original leader off the court for me, you know, a role model as far as how he handled himself. So I talked to him a lot, so it was hard to see him go. But like I said, it's a business.
What specifically did you take away from Lou in terms of the way he conducted himself and stuff like that?
I mean, he just knew the ins and outs of this league. You know, what to do to survive. You know, coming in from what he came in from, young guy coming into this league and then sticking to what he is now. Traded here and there, but he made the best out of every situation. So and he was strong mentally.
Being gone, do you feel even more on your shoulders to step up as a leader?
Yeah, but I feel like everybody should look at it that way, but I'm definitely going to take pride into trying to do that more.